Now, Apollo House, the NAM-owned property taken over by homeless campaigners Home Sweet Home last week, is at maximum capacity and can't accept any new residents at the moment. Lawyers for Mazars, the receivers to the property, have said the building must be vacated. Meanwhile, a motion has been submitted to Dublin City Council's North Area Committee meeting in Coolock calling for official recognition of Apollo House as emergency accommodation. What has been achieved in the last few days by Home Sweet Home, and also what are its limitations? Father Peter McVerry joins me now. Good evening.
Good evening.
Now, you've said that this is not the solution to homelessness, but it is taking people off the streets. So what are your reservations about it?
Well, first, obviously, and the Home Sweet Home crowd know it's not the answer to homelessness. The solution to homelessness is to give people a home, and this is not a home. But this will take people off the streets over Christmas. I have supported them to that extent. I think they have shown a passion for addressing this problem and an urgency for addressing this problem, which has been sadly lacking in government responses to the problem of homelessness. They have mobilised the whole country, and they have enormous support from the public. They've had hundreds of offers to volunteer, and they have now actually asked the public not to donate any more food or stuff, because they have had so much donated to them already. There's been massive, massive support, and I'm sure this is going to put special pressure on government to up its game and to address the problem of homelessness much more urgently. So in that sense, I think they have achieved a huge amount. They're also going to be, there's going to be far, far less people on the streets over Christmas because of this initiative. And that's a great thing.
However, it's not a solution.
And there are certain problems with it. You know, there's no insurance on the building, for example. It has its dangers. But I think what they're doing is very admirable.
It has its dangers. What, do you mean dangers inherent in having no insurance, or do you mean broader dangers?
I think some of the people who are homeless would have multiple needs. And I think they need a level of support that wouldn't be available from the volunteers in that building. Nevertheless, having said that, they're far more at risk on the streets than they are in that building. And the organisers there are absolutely, they have organised everything extremely efficiently. They are determined it will be a drink and drug free facility. They are determined that there will be no problems arising as a result of putting how many extra people in accommodation. Many of the people being accommodated will be in single rooms, and we've been asking for that for a long time, and the government haven't. They've been opening emergency accommodation, which is dormitory style, and many people won't go into that. Much of the accommodation in this building will be single rooms. So I think while there are some difficulties with it, and they know it's only temporary, they know they're going to get kicked out, they know an injunction is going to be taken against them, and they will have to leave.
So it hasn't happened yet, though. Would you be in favour of that motion before Dublin City Council Committee being passed? You know, that would give official recognition as emergency accommodation.
The building would need extremely expensive adaptation to become suitable even for emergency accommodation to a standard that the government would want and that we would want. This is an emergency response to get people off the streets for Christmas, and it's succeeding in doing that. However, they do highlight the absurdity of so many empty buildings around this country lying there vacant while people are on the street, and they do show that if the political will is there, those buildings can be used. I've always advocated the government should take compulsory purchase orders on empty buildings and bring them back into use as residential buildings as quickly as possible. So they have shown up the absurdity of buildings without people and people without buildings.
And they've shown up something else as well, I think, Peter McVerry. We were told by government that the opening of the new beds over the last, since the, was it the 9th of December, would mean that there was a bed for everybody who needed it. But clearly not, because they're already at full capacity.
No, clearly not. There are the number of beds being opened wouldn't address the needs of everybody who was counted as sleeping rough on the last count a couple of weeks ago. So there would still be a shortfall of beds. But the main problem, many homeless people will not go into those emergency accommodation because they're sharing rooms with 3 or 4 or 6 or 10 other people, and they find themselves intimidated, bullied, offered drugs, being threatened and assaulted in those buildings.
So a setup like Apollo House, temporary or otherwise, is addressing those very needs that you're talking about, but not going into dormitories, being able to have a private separate room.
It will certainly have a lot of that, but I think there will be in this Apollo House a sense of community. There's a sense of everybody's in this together. Many of the people who are organising this were themselves homeless people.
That's all right.
Were themselves homeless people, and they know the problems, they know the risks, they know what has to be done, and so I think there will be a sense of community created in Apollo House, which is wonderful, and it means that people will feel safe there because they, first of all, the people who are running it are much like themselves. As I say, they were once themselves, some of them homeless, and they will build a bond with the other people who are using it on a regular basis.
It's a community effort, really, ground up, but you are worried about its survival, even if they are allowed to stay or even if they are able to stay throughout Christmas and on into January. Have you concerns about their capacity to continue the work? Because it is going to require a lot of people.
It is, but they have had hundreds of volunteers offering to help. I don't think there will be any problem with the capacity to continue that and to continue it for a long time. My guess is, and it's purely only a guess, that the receivers will, in the new year, look for a High Court injunction to get them out. And I think if that happens, they will leave.
And if you can harness that energy, if you can harness that energy, if you can harness that community effort and that desire by people to play their part and to make a contribution, they can help you. They can help in so many areas.
They can, of course. In fact, some of our staff were themselves homeless drug users only maybe a few years before we employed them. And our ideal is to employ those people insofar as we can and as far as they're capable of doing it. Yeah, there is they have harnessed a huge energy and they have done more to raise the profile of homelessness and the absurdity of not being able to address this problem of homelessness adequately. They've done far more to do that than me and all the other voluntary agencies have over the years.
Father Peter McVerry, thank you very much.